A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6th Feb, on the front page you have Trust Formed for Ram Temple Construction, Prime Minister. So, Prime Minister has now announced that there will be a trust with 15 trustees, including one Dalit, who would be looking into the formation of the Ram Temple. So, this is as per the judgment of the Supreme Court. So, the Supreme Court had asked for the government to set up a trust to track temple formation. So the key points of the announcement regarding construction of Ram Temple have been put forth here, you can see. So one is this 15 member trust. It has been named Shri Ram Janmabhoomi Tirth Kshetra. It will oversee the construction of the temple. The trust will be empowered to take independent decisions on the construction and of the temple and other related subjects. And government will transfer the whole of the approximately 67.703 acres acquired land to the new trust. The entire chunk of land will go to the trust, and its members have also been announced. You can see the list is given here, the 15 members. And two prominent practicing Hindus will be nominated by the board of trust. These two Hindu IAS officers. So these will be Hindus and they'll be IAS officers below the rank of joint secretary. So they'll be appointed by the center and UP government, and Ayodhya district collector will be the ex-officio trustee. And this is UP government allots 5 acres for building mosque. So Uttar Pradesh government has allotted 5 acres of land for construction of the Babri Masjid, a mosque as such. So this will be land allotted to the Sunni Central Waqf Board. So this is in Dhannipur village in Ayodhya, around 25 kilometers from the site where Babri Masjid once stood. Land is 18 kilometers from the district headquarters on Lucknow State Highway. Then below you have Center moved Supreme Court in Nirbhaya case. So central government has moved Supreme Court after Delhi High Court has rejected its plea. So what central government wants is that death sentences be executed separately in the Nirbhaya case, because we are seeing the co-convicts are applying for curative petitions and mercy petitions separately. So this is further delaying the process of hanging. And actually there's a Supreme Court ruling earlier that co-convicts cannot be hanged separately. They should all exhaust their petitions, mercy petitions, curative petitions, and eventually they can be hanged together. So central government wants death sentences to be executed separately. So since Delhi High Court rejected it, they have moved Supreme Court. And this is again regarding NPR. Odisha government has issued notification for carrying house listing operations as part of census, but no word on conducting NPR. And this is in the context of Delhi Legislative Assembly elections. On page 5 you have MP cabinet passes resolution against Citizenship Amendment Act, calls to abrogate it. So NPR update, without seeking new information, is what state government says should be done. And this is Sunni Central Waqf Board not representative of Muslims. So this is All India Muslim Personal Law Board, who has said that Sunni Central Waqf Board, which will get 5 acres of land in Ayodhya for construction of a mosque, is not representative of entire Muslim community. And they said that the Waqf Board, if the Waqf Board accepts the center's offer, it should not be considered a decision of all Muslims of the country. So its stand is that we will not take any land in Ayodhya. In the judgment, it was said that 67 acres of land acquired by center will be used only for 4 purposes: temple, mosque, library, that is a rest, and a resting place. So if any land is left, then it will be returned to owners. Hence the land for the mosque should be given from this 67 acres of land itself. On page 9 you have PM pitches for boost to defense exports. So we are actually importing defense rather than, but then the Prime Minister talks of exports. So even the budget allocation to defense has been low and there are critical requirements which need to be fulfilled. So imports as such are due. And exports, of course, should be enhanced. Rather, the government should become, the country should become self-sufficient in defense. It should be make in India in defense. So startups and micro, small and medium enterprises will be given emphasis for defense exports too. And we have been importing, like the Scorpion submarine has been imported from Naval Group of France. So six Scorpion submarines have to be delivered by 2022. Now the third one has been delivered, which is named Karanj. And this is Supreme Court firm on opening command posts to women. So government note had cast doubt on women officers matching up to men in physical prowess. So you know, now the Supreme Court also has but re-emphasized that women should be allowed in command posts in army. So Solicitor General said that women should not strive to equal men but go far ahead of them. So this is what he said in the Supreme Court. So at least, you know, why do women strive to be equal to men when they are and can be far ahead? So such are the arguments being given. And government says that we would definitely see women officers rise to command posts in the army. And there are many services in addition to combat posts. So what the government does not want is women in combat posts. So here you can see. So army says the physiological limitations of women officers are there. And they have lower physical standards compared to men, and prolonged absence due to pregnancy, children's education, husband's career prospects, etc., were great challenges for women officers to meet the exigencies of services. So physical prowess is also being put forth as a reason why the government does not want women in combat posts. So these are the arguments put forth before the Supreme Court. So also they say that posting women officers in all male units has its own peculiar dynamics. Then below you have Central Pollution Control Board pulls up 14 coal plants. So they had not complied with the deadline to limit sulfur dioxide emission. So these are plants, the deadline for complying was December 31, 2019. So these are five plants in Haryana, three in Punjab, two in UP, and two in Andhra Pradesh, two in Telangana, one in Tamil Nadu. So all across the country. On editorial page, the first editorial is Polarized State of Union. So this is regarding American politics. The presidential elections are due in USA. So it says there is more at stake in American politics for people world over than ever before. So who will be elected as the next US president? Whether Donald Trump gets re-elected or we get a new president. So that is going to affect world politics too. And this is purifying water. So this is regarding yesterday's news that the Home Ministry came up with a draft notification saying that membrane-based water purification systems would be banned because especially these are the reverse osmosis water filters. So they'll be barred for domestic use if the water meets BIS standards. So what is being stated in this editorial is that effort must be to ensure BIS standard water is available at customers' end. Not banning ROs. So it's actually National Green Tribunal which had given an order because home filters waste nearly 80% of water during treatment. So that is why it was stated. And also with removal of salts, so they remove essential nutrients too. So vital nutrients can be cut. So that is why reverse osmosis machines should be banned is what NGT stated. And for put this into effect now, Home Ministry came up with this notification. Then the lead article is Fashioning the Framework of a New India. So it says a major solution to the present economic crisis is to go in for inclusive growth, shared prosperity, not making the rich richer, not following the capitalist policy, but following the socialist policy, putting money in the hands of the people, which the survey and the budget both have rejected. They emphasize on capitalist policies. And this is course correction for the Speaker's office. So this talks about how India's electoral system and political conventions shadow the office of the speaker. So a major revamp is necessary in the post of the speaker. So this is a very important article on this. Even the Supreme Court has spoken. On op-ed page, you have this coverage on N-coronavirus. So it says response of health workers to N-coronavirus outbreak is been undermined by rumor mongering. So this is time for solidarity, not stigma. But what we are seeing is rumors spreading on N-coronavirus. On page 13, you have this thousands of people who converge on the premises of this 1000-year-old Sri Brihadeshwar temple in Thanjavur, Tamil Nadu for its consecration. So the event, which was witnessed by Maratha royal family members led by Prince Babaji Raja Bhosle Chhatrapati, and this event was held after 23 years now. And below you have Supreme Court panel recommends several prison reforms. So it recommends phone call a day, one phone call a day, cleaner kitchens, etc. So these are several recommendations, like modern cooking facilities, canteens to buy essential items, trial through video conferencing. So these are the recommendations to reform prisons, which has been made by the panel appointed by the Supreme Court. And this is surrogate mothers need not be close kin. So a surrogate mother need not be a close relative. So this has been recommended as such, the Rajya Sabha Select Committee on Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019. So it also advocates omission of 5-year limit before seeking surrogacy. So you have to wait for 5 years. If you're not having a child, then you can seek surrogacy. So some major changes have been suggested by 23-member committee, which has presented its report to the Rajya Sabha. So this is Rajya Sabha Select Committee. So you should know about this bill, Surrogacy Regulation Bill, which has been, which is yet to be passed by the Rajya Sabha. So it has been referred to committee. It has been, the bill was referred to it by the Lok Sabha in November 2019. Then on international page, again, you have the same coverage on presidential elections and end coronavirus in China. So you can skip it for today. On business page, you have cooperative banks to come under RBI purview. So regulator RBI gets powers to supersede board of any such bank in financial distress. So we have seen this case with the cooperative bank, that is PMC Bank, Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank Crisis. So now Union Cabinet has approved an amendment to Banking Regulation Act to bring 1,540 cooperative banks under RBI regulation. And this is bill to resolve disputed income tax cases introduced in Lok Sabha. So this is Vivad Se Vishwas Bill, which aims to settle 9.32 lakh crore cases. Worth of cases of income tax disputes. So Finance Minister has introduced this bill in Lok Sabha. So these disputes can be settled amicably. So here is the detail of this bill too. The opposition said that the bill's name was not only an attempt to impose Hindi but will also hurt tax collection efforts. Vivad Se Vishwas. And below you have government reviewing dividend tax rules for real estate infra investment trust. So this we had seen in news yesterday too. So government is reviewing the negative impacts of scrapping the dividend distribution tax as announced in the budget for investors in real estate investment trust and infrastructure investment trust. And below you have service index hits 7-year high in January. So India's service sector activity has surged to a 7-year high, driven by sharp increase in new business orders. So this is according to IHS Market India Service Business Index, Activity Index, which is a private sector survey held every month. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.